In the middle of the night, you walk into the bathroom. What is that? It's shaped like a fish and even has shimmering scales. But it also has legs, 6 of them. This insect is a fire brat. Fire brats and their close relative, the silverfish, don't come out of your drain as it might seem. They just happened to wander into your sink and can't climb out. Sorry, pal. They live in dark places, hiding in your walls or a stack of newspapers. If they're near a source of warmth, all the better. They get the name fire brat from their attraction to heat. And they like to live where they eat. This page could make a tasty meal. Fire brats and silverfish are the original bookworms. They love the books you keep meaning to open. They also love the cereal in your kitchen. Look closely. You'll see traits some of the earliest insects had, around 400 million years ago. Take these 3 long filaments. The 2 outer ones are called cerci. They work like antennae, detecting chemicals and predators, like this house centipede. Other insects, like cockroaches, have a short pair of cerci. But very few insects have this 3rd one, called the median caudal filament. Its tiny hairs detect the faintest air currents. A fire brat is born as a mini version of itself. That's rare for insects. This ancient way of developing is called a metabole. It's totally different than the metamorphosis an insect like a butterfly goes through, from caterpillar to pupa to adult. That's called holometabole. This complete transformation is an advantage. The caterpillar feeds on leaves, the adult nectar. So a butterfly doesn't compete with its younger self for food. But a fire brat does, sharing its food at every life stage. Luckily, it can go months between meals. Like the original insects, fire brats don't grow wings. Most insects do. I mean, wings are useful. You can reach different kinds of food and steer clear of predators. The diversity of insects exploded when wings appeared. That's why there's hundreds of thousands of species of flies. Yes, mosquitoes are flies. And only a few hundred species of fire brats and silverfish. Maybe you're thinking, why didn't fire brats just change to be more like other insects? The thing is, evolving doesn't mean an animal or plant keeps moving towards some ideal version of itself. All it has to do to survive is keep up a big enough population. And fire brats have for millions of years. Also, as far as pests go, they're not so bad. They don't bite or sting, and they have enzymes in their gut that digest tough cellulose. One day, we might even be able to harness those enzymes to make biofuels from plants. Not bad at all for an insect firmly set in its ways. Hi, it's Laura. Getting a little tired of your roommates right now? Here's a playlist of some deep look critters that would happily move in if you let them, like ants, fleas, termites, and yes, bedbugs. Also, please don't forget to subscribe and click that little notification bell. Thanks for watching.